Hi, this is Christina from AquariumBeefo.com. I'm coming to you today from our backyard where we're filming due to the quarantine of COVID-19. All right, so you got your first shipment of corals from AquariumBeefo.com, and today we're gonna help you get them successfully into your tank. All right, first up, you got a fathead dendrophilia. This is an amazing coral because first of all, they're very rare, but a lot of people get confused about dendrophilias and sun corals alike, because oftentimes when they look at them, they go, but wait a minute, it doesn't look anything like the picture. Well, that's because the polyps are still down inside of the coral. Duncan corals also do this as well. So you've got to give them a few minutes. Once they get into your tank, you start feeding your tank, you're going to see them start to polyp out. So next thing up that I get a lot of questions about was the green star polyps. And the same kind of thing happens with them. Their polyps actually come out of a pink skin. You can't see it right now because currently they're out and they look all beautiful and pretty with their polyps out. But once we get them into the water and start messing with them, the polyps will retract and you'll be able to see their pink skin. And oftentimes people say, but these are dead. No, they're not dead. They just need a few more minutes to get adjusted to your aquarium and start to bring their polyps out. All right, the other thing you got was one of our beautiful purple and green acros. This is a beautiful coral. So we're going to show you once again how to get this successfully out of the bag and into your tank. We also have a beautiful, it is an amazing piece of zoanthids. It looks like a bloodsucker zoanthid, and this is an amazing piece. These will grow very, very quickly if you feed your tank. So phytoplankton, which we also sell, you can always feed that a couple of times a week, and you'll see exponential growth with all of your corals. Also, we have a mystic sunset. This is a Monty, and this is an amazing piece of coral. It's got a pink body with a purpley blue polyp. Once again, sometimes you won't see the polyps while they're in transit or until they get happy into your tank, but just give them a few minutes. All right, so how do we get this out of the tank, out of the bags and into the tank successfully? All right, so first things first, let me show you a little bit about the way that we actually bag and ship our corals. You'll notice that they are in this bag very firmly, and that is so that we don't want them banging around and getting damaged on the side of the bag. So we actually have a hole drilled at the end of the plug, and then we use fishing line and we string it through and we secure it at the top. This way, no matter what happens, the coral is going to be secured in there. Now, once again, guys, sometimes it does happen that the coral comes off the plug. We've got other videos though to address that and to help you fix those type of issues. All right, so first things first, we're gonna take and we're gonna cut along the seam of the bag, and we're just gonna let this water come in here like this. Now remember guys, if corals are out of water for a few seconds, it's really not a big deal, so don't panic about that. Then you can just take and cut the rest of the bag open like this, take and fold the bag down. And now you can see that the fishing line is exposed, and you're just gonna cut the fishing line right there, and now the coral is successfully back into the water that it traveled in. Now remember guys, because we have two large systems, but we maintain the same water chemistry in both of our systems, you can use all the water. You don't have to worry about did it come from which system. None of that is anything to worry about. So once again, cut the bag off, fold the bag down so that you can expose the plug, and then just cut it off from the fishing line. Now this is the green star polyps I wanted you to see. So just take a look at what they look like once the polyps retract and go inside the skin, because it's really amazing. And most importantly, guys, I'm afraid that people have thrown this poor coral away thinking that it was dead without giving it an ample time to actually become the beautiful coral that it is when its polyps are out. So always make sure that you give them time. As you can see, the pink skin really starting to show, the polyps are retracting. This is what it's gonna look like for even 1, 2, 3, 4 days in your tank. But remember, we give you a 14-day guarantee. So if in 14 days it doesn't look any different, of course, send us an email, send us some pictures. Of course, we're gonna take care of you. All right, now the other thing to keep in mind while you're doing your acclimation is that some corals are not really friendly with each other, okay? And remember guys, this is a fight for territory, a fight for real estate. You know, so in where we live, we have very little real estate available, and it's very expensive what is available. And so that's the way the corals look at your tank as well. So unfortunately, what they use is they use stinging cells to fight against each other, kill off a coral that's too close, and be able to take over that area. So we always want to make sure that we keep the corals separated. All right, last but not least, the dendrophilia. Honestly, guys, this is probably my most favorite coral. I love sun corals. I love dendros. They're super beautiful. They grow really, really easily. They love to be fed. You can even set your clock to them. So let's just say that you decide at 6 o'clock every day, you're gonna feed this guy. Amazingly enough, at 6 o'clock every day, he will come out and be ready for his dinner. All right, so we are all successfully into the bowl. And now we're just gonna start bringing our tank water in, okay? Now remember, guys, we keep our parameters at about alkalinity of around 8, calcium around 400 to 420, phosphates around 0.05 to 0.1, nitrates usually between 10 and 20. So if your parameters are anywhere close to this, you really don't have to do a 2-hour acclimation, provided that you're not dealing with any temperature issues. Okay, keep our salinity stable at 1.025. Okay, so basically all I'm doing is I'm just bringing in tank water. I would suggest, if you're not worried about any kind of a temperature issue, to allow this process to take about an hour, and you're just gonna keep bringing water in. The bowl gets too full that you're using, obviously you're just gonna scoop out, take some out, put more tank water in until you have, you know, a balance of your water versus what they were shipped in. And then all you have to do is take these guys and put them into your tank. All right, it was nice helping you through this. I hope that it was beneficial, and we'll see you again, aquariumdepot.com.